معي وأدعو السيدة كول مستشارة تقنية ومندوبة إضافية للعمال بألمانيا للاقتراب من المنصة.
Mr. President, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, 20 years ago, my country, Hungary, which I represent of the employer side, was a pioneer among the Central and East European countries in the transition from a plain to a market economy, from a despotic to a democratic political system. No wonder that Hungary is among the first now in experiencing the contradictions inherent in the democratic system as well. 20 years ago, gossip at the corridors of the Palais of Nations said that Hungarians are very smart, entering the revolving door behind you, but coming out in front. Nowadays, however, I often read from empathic eyes of my colleagues that so Hungarians went in the revolving door first, they are still waiting for them. Hungary is struggling with a lot of economic, social and political difficulties these days. The root of the political and social problems, in my opinion, stems from the wrong economic policy. There is a high budget deficit, an exaggerated wage flow, which is not in balance with the work done, and consequently the tension between the increased new European demands and the reduced opportunities of the recession-torn economy. The misunderstanding of fundamental human rights, the lack of realization of the limits of freedom, the lack of experience in running a democracy, and to the spectacular quarreling of the political forces have all contributed to the current state of economy. Of course, I am aware of that many other European countries face the same challenges, namely those the freedom of assembly mean, which is one of the most fundamental human rights, that any group has the right to march on the streets without any preliminary control. Furthermore, to set cars and shops on fire and prevent police action by force. Lengthy and strongly protest appear in other European countries too. So in Hungary, after 40 years of communist despotism, we protect the rights of strike without any sense. Today, any tiny group working in the public sector can go on strike even when there is no agreement on the sufficient level of services. Some trade unions call for strike even if they carry out such public services, the disruption of which does not express dissatisfaction with the employers at all, and they use violent and criminal methods, such as taking the residents to hostage in the capital. Hungarian employers all respect and are aware of the freedom of expression, objection and association as well, which are among the fundamental ILO principles. Every constitutional country must consider them as benchmarks, only with one exception, when the aim is to destroy the rule of the law itself. The freedom of association must not allow the creation of associations that aim at the demonstrative regulation and intimidation of minorities and the revival of the symbols of the dark shadows of the past. In a democracy, all opinions are free, except the ones that call for destruction of democracy itself. We employers are not only eager to follow the debates that are on the agenda of the 97th ILO conference, but we participate in them with enthusiasm, whether they are on capacity building in ILO or on the improvement of productivity and employment. It is our inner interest to close these debates successfully. In the course of the several hundred years of Hungarian history, our country made several attempts to catch up with the European center, and to meet the challenges of economic and social modernization. Now, at the dawn of the 21st century, Hungary got a historical chance to make this centuries-old dream come true. I hope that the selfish social groups and, in my point of view, the not trustworthy political elite and the trade unions that misinterpret their roles and flirt with criminal and illegal methods will not derail Hungary from the track of modernization, and we will not jeopardize Hungary's historical chance. I wish you and us success to all this. Thank you for your attention.
شكراً. كلمة للسيدة كول. وأدعو السيد رودريغيز وزير العمل والشؤون الاجتماعية بغواتيمالا للاقتراب من المنصة.
Sehr geehrter Herr Vorsitzender, liebe Kolleginnen und Kollegen, sehr geehrte Damen und Herren, ich danke für die Ehre, heute hier im Namen des Deutschen Gewerkschaftsbundes vor dieser Generalversammlung sprechen zu dürfen. Ich möchte auf einige Punkte aus dem Bericht des Generaldirektors über menschenwürdige Arbeit und kommende strategische Herausforderungen hier eingehen. Der Bericht hebt hervor, dass die Regulierung der Finanzmärkte